Well, for the most part, most people on this march are going to be people who are anti-Brexit. They want Brexit stopped altogether. But officially, what they're rallying for today is to have a second referendum or a so-called people's vote.
Hey guys, it's Brexit!
I'm Jenna Munoz, your narrator.
Stephanie Sanchez, a supporter of Hard Brexit.
I'm Brenda Brolic, and I'm anti-Brexit.
And I'm Journey Lopez, your local teen translator.
In Europe, chaos ensues as the dilemma of Brexit continues to plague the citizens of the UK and the EU.
The EU, the European Union, is an economic political partnership with 28 countries. It's kind of like being in a relationship with someone, except in this case you have 28 partners. The UK is the United Kingdom, which includes Northern Ireland, Wales, England, and Scotland.
Being in the EU is expensive, I say. We have to give a net contribution to the EU to help out other countries, and our local markets can't compete with cheap foreign products. Plus, who knows who is crossing over the border? We need a tighter grip on immigration.
The UK wouldn't be the only one affected if Brexit were to happen. The rest of the European countries would also face economic trouble, as they would have a hard time making trade agreements. Also, it would make the EU fall down on a world power ladder, which would raise other countries like China and the United States to have a higher world power status.
Essentially, it would cause chaos with migration and trade, which is what countries such as Russia would want. Them commies. And it would cause a lot of problems with money. You know what they say? No money, mo problems.
Includes EU citizenship for all members, free movement, ability to vote and run as a candidate in any EU elections, single market and have a common currency, the euro, and a central banking system. Brexit was originally voted on June 23, 2016. They were to leave the EU on March 29, 2019. Then they moved the date to April 22, 2019. However, they still haven't left the EU. They're planning to leave the EU by October 31st, 2019. If the UK continues to delay, they might have to leave with no deal between the UK and the EU.
I oppose Brexit. I think it is absurd, but it would be even worse if Theresa May can't make a deal. A no deal would mean conflict in the government and the community, and harm to the government of both places. Plus, people in the EU who are from the UK would have no assurance that they could stay where they are, or they have to move back home immediately, or have to apply for settlement to stay where they are. The same goes for people from the EU living in the UK, and it would cause violence between the border of Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland.
FYI, Theresa May is the Prime Minister of Britain, which is the American equivalent to the president.
Ugh, the Theresa May deal, however, is much too soft. But that deal, why even call it Brexit? We will like hard immigration. For example, control free movement and hard borders to stop the flow of immigrants.
With Brexit in progress, many think British perceptions of immigration and foreigners will be more negative and increase racial tension. It is important to get your news from multiple outlets because there are different perspectives from different people on the issue of Brexit. It's important to have your own opinion based on evidence and perspectives of people.
There is a lot of bias in the media because people want to be right and have more people agree with them. Sometimes they will exaggerate or cover the truth just to make a point. So, make sure you get your information from other sources and not just Discover on Snapchat.
So why do people want to leave or stay, and what are the disadvantages and advantages of both?
We should leave because we have to contribute money to the poorer countries. In fact, the bill is rising. We had an £11.3 billion contribution. EU membership makes it difficult for the UK to trade with countries outside the EU trade. Has little restriction on migration and immigrants, and it's better for small UK vendors because there's less competition. The advantage of hard Brexit is that in-country merchants and markets are able to flourish on their own. The harder Brexit will have an advantage of more freedom once the harder Brexit is ruled on, making more trades, deals, rules, and government.
However, disadvantages for a hard Brexit would be trading or using out-of-country traded goods that will be inspected and taxed on, and trying to get agreements with the US and China would cause conflict due to the agreements the US has with the EU.
We should remain part of the EU because it causes fewer problems, it's better for both economies, people would not have to move or worry about living situations, and they would know what is coming in the future. If they leave, they don't know the extent of the consequences. Leaving could cause the economy to fail. However, a softer approach would be better than a hard Brexit. Some advantages of a soft Brexit include trade with other countries without tariffs. We don't have to worry about the living situation of the people living in a different country due to free movement, and fewer problems with the economy.
Disadvantages to a soft Brexit include conflict with some of the community and people in Parliament. They would be upset that there wasn't complete separation from the EU, which is what most people wanted.
We believe that the approach of the softer Brexit would be a better route for the United Kingdom and the European Union, because it allows fewer trade problems and less tension between Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland because of softer migration laws.
The people living in the EU will be able to stay where they are because they moved to Britain through the EU. Same goes for the people living in the United Kingdom.
Brexit also affects Americans, especially with their trade relations. The US would make us have to create new deals with the UK if they separated from the EU. Also, we should make new deals with the EU so the past amends are not broken or violated when trading with the UK.
See, it would be easier for the Americans to just deal with one big group rather than smaller countries. I am considerate of the Americans as well. I mean, Brexit would make British imports more expensive, strain US and EU alliances, since Britain is the biggest English speaker member in the EU, and threaten sanctions reliability. Plus, Americans will need to pay for visas to go to the UK, which will be even more expensive.
Humbug.
Okay, so higher tariffs on import mean your tea from Britain will cost more money. It'll threaten relations with the US and EU alliances because the UK is basically the US's Google Translate. Without it, the US would have trouble understanding the needs of other countries. It also threatens sanctions to hold individuals or countries accountable for their actions. The reliability of these sanctions are threatened because, without the UK, the EU and the US would have a harder time enforcing these decisions. And finally, a visa is like a Disneyland ticket. It allows you to travel to different places in the park. EU, also like a Disneyland ticket, they are getting more expensive.
Thank you for watching!